welcome to the Primetime Sports Show. And today I have Coach Allison with me from the Hialeah Miami Lakes High School football team. Welcome, Coach.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank you for coming to my office. Good seeing you, man.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure. So, I know you have a background of coaching, you know, and this is not really your first time at Hialeah Miami Lakes. You know, what decisions did you make to, you know, make you want to come back to the school and become the head coach as a football coaching program?
Well, this is my alma mater. You know, I graduated here in 2001. So even when I was here as a coordinator a couple years ago, I always wanted to come back to my school and bring back the tradition that I've been used to. Mm-hmm. So that was my main thing behind it. There's been other positions that I could have interviewed for, being a coordinator so long, but HML was pretty much the only one that I really wanted.
Okay. And I know this is not your first year with a head coaching spot, and you've been coaching for, you know, a couple of years. When did you start with the coaching high school?
I actually started coaching in college. I went to Methodist University, which is Division III in North Carolina. And I went up there, and I played my first year. And I was like, you know what? I'm not finna make next level. So after that, I decided I want to coach. And my offensive line coach, he saw it in me, and he was like, man, I'm going to introduce you to these high school coaches. And basically, my second year in college, I started coaching high school football.
Oh, wow. So, how was it, you know, going to North Carolina? How was the atmosphere different from Miami?
It's completely different. Ain't no nightlife. I know that for a fact. But, I mean, it was different, man. People a whole lot nicer. You know, they treat you good. It was different, man. You far away from home, but you learn how to grow up when you're that far away from home.
Okay, and you said your second year in college, you started coaching high school, or was you like a assistant at your school?
I started coaching high school my second year. Schools were like 2 miles away, and I just started coaching. I got introduced to the coaches. I was coaching JV, mm-hmm. Coaching the O-line, and I coached there my second year in school, and my third and fourth year in school, I kind of chilled, but as soon as I got back to Miami, I actually came to Hialeah Miami Lakes.
Okay, and being so young coaching high school football, did the kids give you any issues, nothing like that?
Man, when you first start off coaching and you young, you think you're still one of them. You want to run the drills with them. You want to do everything that they still doing and talk stuff to them like, man, I could do it better than you. But I never really got any flack because I'm like I'm a player's coach. I treat them respect, they treat me respect, but I know the boundaries.
Okay. And this is not, like I said earlier, this is not your first head job. How did that feel when you got your first head coaching job? And that was back in North Miami High School?
That was North Miami High School. I got my first head job in 2008, 3 years out of college at 24. And it was a whirlwind, I ain't even gonna lie. And I was only actually head coach for 1 year because they gave me an interim position, and then a new principal came and he brought his own people in. But it was actually a whirlwind, and I learned a lot from it that actually prepared me for this current moment, my second go around.
Okay. So, coming back to HML, you know, the program has been kind of on a downfall the last couple of years. You know, what kind of plans do you have, you know, for bringing it from a downfall to a successful program?
Well, first thing is, we gotta, at Hialeah Miami Lakes, is keep all our kids here that belong here. Because what's been happening, a lot of kids been transferring out, going to other schools, because Hialeah Miami Lakes is a school that's been, you know, very productive. Right now, it's probably like 6 players that's, you know, in the NFL. You know, the big names right now, you got Thaddeus played for Buffalo Bills, Armando Allen, you know, he's with Chicago. I think he got hurt, he might have been released recently. And we got a couple other. So, I mean, it's just about bringing the tradition back. So, you know, number one, keep the kids that belong here. Mm-hmm. After that, you know, establish my mindset on my kids, the type of philosophy that I have for my program. And we're already starting to establish that. And once we establish who we are as a program, my brand, my coach's brand, I think we'll move forward from that.
Thank you. And, you hit one of my points that I wanted to get to with the, you know, every year you have talent, you have young talent, but you know when they get older, they like transferring out. You hit one of my points. And do you have like any, you know, any feel or points of why is that so much a common issue with kids transferring as they get older?
Well, the political answer is that, you know, kids just, you know, sometimes want to change. They're not feeling the coach. The real answer is the big time schools in Dade County, they go for your kids. And when I say big time schools, I mean the schools that's been winning the state championships. So those schools sometimes tend to have a lot more to offer than the smaller schools. But what the kids don't realize, if you stay here and your friends stay here, you got the same potential to win.
Correct.
Those big schools is what they're doing is they're pulling from all the little school all the best players, and then they build an all-star team. And it's kind of hard to compete with that. But the way I feel you can keep your kids, if you can keep them, is just by being real with them. Mm-hmm. Putting the same opportunities in front of them that the big schools put in front of them. Clinics, combines, and, you know, a chance for success. Because all I think the kids want is to be successful, a chance to win. Mm-hmm.
And so, with that being said, how, with the big schools and, you know, in Dade County, a couple of big schools, you know, powerhouses, do you feel like you're going to try to get HML as the powerhouse for like a, you know, a decade or so?
Well, right now I got a three-year plan. My three-year plan is within the next 3 years to make it to a state championship game. This year, in all reality, based on our district and our alignment, I feel like we can make the playoffs with the current talent that's coming back. Because a lot of the kids were 9th and 10th graders. So my plan is really for these guys that's 9th graders now, in 3 years, once I've input my philosophy and my brand on them, to be there in that third year in the state championship game, competing for the title. But I feel I can, man, just by keeping my kids, going out to the park and getting the kids here that belong here, and just building something, you know, making it that the kids want to be here, showing them that it's HML, man, we got a strong tradition. I think we won our first state championship in 75, and it's been a while, but we've had a lot of playoff teams.
Mm-hmm.
So we can take it back there, man, if our kids stay home and we just put, you know, put them in a good situation to win.
Okay, thank you. And, you know, last but not least, you know, leaving HML and coming back, are they making you feel welcome, you know?
I feel very welcome, man. I feel very welcome by, you know, former alumni. You know, everybody got Facebook. I put it on Facebook, all my friends, and even alumni that I don't know, you know, they're very excited about the change. You know, they got one goal here, HML beat Hialeah. So, you know, number one on the checklist is beat Hialeah. But everybody been, you know, open arms, you know, showing a lot of support, and I just look forward to, you know, to the upcoming season.
Okay, okay. Once again, that was Coach Allison of the Hialeah Miami Lakes High School in Miami. And thanks for being on the show, Coach Allison.
All right, thank you, man. Have a good day.
What you came for? Don't you wish you came more? Girl, what you playing for?